Exposure to even a small amount of spilled mercury can cause a variety of health effects. The health effects of mercury depend on how much and how long you breathe in the vapors.
When elemental mercury is spilled or a device containing mercury breaks, the spilled mercury will produce an invisible, odorless vapor that can make you sick. When mercury is heated or dispersed into tiny beads, it will vaporize very quickly and can be more dangerous. Exposure can last a long time if the spilled mercury is not cleaned up promptly and thoroughly. Breathing mercury vapors is the most common way to be exposed to elemental mercury and is the most harmful to your health. Very little mercury is absorbed from touching it. However, getting mercury on your skin or clothing increases the likelihood of spreading it and of inhaling vapors coming off of mercury stuck to your clothing. If mercury is swallowed, most of it passes through your body and very little is absorbed, with the exception of a broken compact fluorescent bulb, which has a minute amount of mercury. Even a small spill, such as from a broken laboratory thermometer, can produce hazardous amounts of vapor if the room is small enough, warm enough, or people spend a good deal of time there.
For most spills that are identified and cleaned up quickly, most people will be exposed to low levels of mercury vapor for only a short period of time. Health effects are unlikely, and those health effects will improve once people are no longer breathing the vapors that come off of the mercury spill. Health problems usually result from either long-term, low-level, or short-term, high-level mercury exposures. While mercury can impact many organs in the body, the main health effects are on the central nervous system, that is the brain, and on the kidneys. Health effects on the central nervous system include feeling anxious, acting shy, not sleeping well, loss of appetite, and feeling irritable. Pregnant women, infants, and children are especially sensitive to the harmful effects of elemental mercury because of their developing minds and bodies. This is why it's particularly important to identify students who've been exposed to mercury. In the cases of very high exposures, individuals may require testing for mercury levels in their body and medical care. But most spills that typically occur at schools, especially ones detected early and cleaned up properly, lead to short-term, low-level exposures that don't require testing or any medical treatment.